when I started to play lead guitar, what was important to me was attitude, really, is playing from the heart. It was the music that I got into, my influences and all that stuff was stuff that made me feel like that person meant it, and there was some feeling behind it. I didn't know about technique or anything, but I knew that hearing somebody bend a note, that meant a lot, you know, to me. That felt like something. And one of the first guys I heard bend a note was Jeff Beck. So he was, it was Blow by Blow, and then later Got Wired on Jeff Beck. So it was like hearing stuff like, all that stuff, you know, hearing the pick. These are just basic, you know, things that affected me and made me feel great about hearing guitar playing, you know. Paul Kossoff was another guy. Paul Kossoff played with this attitude in his rhythm playing and his lead playing, and he would attack the guitar. He was, I didn't know him, but I think he was kind of a, you know, a little smaller in stature, like guys like Randy, but played with a big sound and just milked it. And he would have this, these, you know, crazy intense vibratos, and the way he played rhythm was really heavy. But he had, you know, that solo for All Right Now is his classic. You know, you got two sides of guitar players. That you got the technical guys that really blow you away with the emotion of a certain thing that they do, and then there's other guys that just play solos like David Gilmour or Paul or Jimmy Page that you can just sing the solo. It's not as technically hard, but it's great. That's important that you're, when you're developing your style, that, you know, when somebody hears you go, if they hear that and they can tell it's you, then that's a win right there. That's a good thing. The way that somebody bends a note, they, you know, little by little, the more years that you play, you'll definitely develop your own sound, and hopefully your own style too. Because you know, when you plug into an amp and you pick up a guitar, you kind of generally go for a certain thing that's in your head, and that's how your sound gets developed, coming from your fingers and returning back to your ears. And then you're developing your sound, and then your style is, for me, it's a mix of a lot of different things. So the attack and the aggression of guys like Paul Kossoff and later Gary Moore, totally, you know, that the way he would do these really aggressive picking patterns, and his legato was insane too. And Randy Rhoads, same thing, you know, all that kind of stuff was really, is like they're playing it like they meant it. So influences, those early guys, Jeff Beck, Jimmy Page, and obviously guys like Blackmore, because Smoke on the Water was out. Hendrix, I couldn't really do much of Hendrix in the beginning, but I loved what I heard, you know. I couldn't really do much of any of those guys when I was 11, but I just love trying and working on it. And then it wasn't until, you know, learning a little scale that somebody taught me that and showing me where it would sound good, that was like, wow, that's amazing. You know, the things that I liked in the beginning were these little basic blues licks and stuff like that I would warm up with, and hammer-ons and vibrato. So I would, like when I pick up a guitar, I do stuff like that, or I might start off just with just a big E chord to kind of make the connection that, okay. And just do some basic things to get my hands to feel confident. You know, a lot of times, if you're feeling a little bit out of sorts and you grab a guitar and you just start to wail, there's not a connection yet between your hands and your head and your heart, all that stuff. This way, I know this is my routine. I just... do some things that make you feel confident. Then you can little by little... And then starting to do, go back to what I first said is some of those little hammer-on pull-off pentatonic things. Just getting a connection. If I'm going for, you know, if I'm not gonna have a chance to really do much warming up, that stuff at least gets me started. And then I might. Work on something where my hands are really working together, which is staccato picking, and then I can kind of lay in some legato on top of that. A lot of times with stuff like that, you gotta really be in a tempo to kind of lock in and make sure you're. Sometimes warming up too is good when you're not so distorted. You're just kind of just. And then eventually you can turn up the gain, but it's nice to practice. Without a lot of gain, just kind of get the connection happening. And by the way, if I don't hit a G chord first, I eventually get there by E. I always do this whole thing, the Gary Moore thing. Then I get down to G. Down to G. I love G is my favorite key to warm up and play. I don't know why.